Hey, Sebastian from the Metal Gods Meltdown, and today I am joined by
Illusions of Grandeur. I'm the Siren.
I'm CM, the bassist.
It's great to be chatting to you this evening. I understand you're coming over to Europe soon. Are you stoked?
Yeah, June. We start June. We'll be there. We'll be in the UK starting June 6th. Doing some personal appearances, but June 10th we're at the Whitney Music Festival in Whitney, Oxfordshire. And then there's going to be some dates that'll be announced right after June 10th. So we'll be in London for a few days. Then we're in Yorkshire, and then there's some surprise dates, but we're waiting for everything. But right as of right now, we arrive our first date June 10th.
Cool, that's going to be amazing. So when was the last time you were in the UK?
2019.
Yeah. Before all the COVID madness and we were in 2019. Again, we launched. We're really happy. We're a great relationship with the Whitney Music Festival. We usually launch our tours
from there.
Yeah. And in 2019, we played the Whitney Music Festival and some shows around the UK, and then we were in the Ukraine.
Okay.
For a month. In 2021, we were going to do pretty much the same thing, except Putin said no, he canceled the tour.
Yeah. I think we're headed to London this time.
We're heading to London. This will be the first time there. Yeah. And London, Yorkshire, like we usually end up in that area a couple of hours outside of London, but we want to spread out. Yeah, definitely Edinburgh and get to Newcastle and, do it's a big country. There's a lot of places to play.
There is a lot of places to play. Yeah. Edinburgh, Scotland's amazing. Bannerman's, that's a fantastic venue up there. I love it. So what about releases and that? Are you going to be releasing any more new music, EP, or even an album this year?
We are pretty excited, actually. Yeah, we're working on the new album now, and I think we're going to have a really cool teaser for everyone. Am I allowed to say that?
Yeah, sure.
We're in the works. We just really have been working on one song in particular, just so we can kind of put it out as a teaser. Cool. So,
yeah, there'll be a single. It'll probably be out at the beginning of the tour. It's called Midnight.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. And it just we're starting to make the record, and usually. Mm-hmm. We want to get a good sense of the record and get it finished before we put anything out. But this song was just spot on right away. It just was so great that the entire band kind of went, we need to put this out as soon as possible. Because it takes us in a totally, not a totally different direction, but it showcases a little darker side of the band and a little more. I think it's heading in the direction we're heading in on the next album, The Siren Rises.
Yes.
So probably before we leave for the UK tour and the European tour in June, this will be out and people will be able to see the video and check out all the platforms and stream it and all that fun stuff.
Awesome. When you go to Europe, are you playing in Belgium?
That's in the works. We just actually got... we're so far out from the tour.
I know, man.
6 months out. There's talk of us playing an open air festival in June in Germany. Mm-hmm. And if we're going to be in Germany, yes, we will probably go into Belgium, Norway, around that general area and do some dates. Yeah. 'Cause why not? We're there.
Yeah.
There's a lot of stuff in the works. But I know it's going to definitely be a string of dates in the UK and then a string of dates in Germany, maybe France.
Cool.
So,
I love Belgium. Belgium's a fantastic place for festivals. Beer and everything else is fantastic. I love it. It's really good.
The best beer like ever.
Yeah, man. I've not been back since COVID and I want to get back desperately. I've got friends over there and I usually go to Alcatraz Festival, Grass Pop, all of those. Fantastic. Brilliant. Okay, then. So I'm going to ask you then, which three bands that would be your ultimate touring buddies? Ultimate bands.
Oh, well, Korn.
Yeah, Korn's definitely always been one of my all-time favorite bands.
Do they have to be playing currently?
Yeah. Dead or alive.
I'm dead or alive. Thin Lizzy. No, I think Korn.
In this moment, I've always wanted to play with. In this moment, I think we'd go well together and you know, we're fortunate enough actually to have a little bit of a relationship with their bass player. He got tattooed by him. Yeah, it's hard to see. That's a tattoo on
my arm from him. Travis Johnson, the bass player, is our tattoo artist.
Really? That's so cool.
Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah. And talk about a really good tattoo artist and just a great person.
Yeah, he's a really sweet soul.
The kindest guy you'll ever meet. So, cool. Yeah, Korn in this moment. And, you know, I would love the tour with Slipknot.
Oh, I would love Shoot the Moon. Yeah, that is a Shoot the Moon. But I would, yeah. Yeah, I have a, I've always loved Slipknot and had like a, you know,
love-hate
thing with Corey Taylor. But now I think just that I'm a little bit older, I have so much respect for him. Like, so it's just turned to a love thing.
Yeah, that's it.
I like it because in 1976 to destroy.
Yeah, not the Kiss. Do you know they're charging? I think it's like cheapest tickets to see Kiss. They're playing up this way, £90. It's just ridiculous, you know. It's just
yeah. The ticket prices are a little out of control.
They are. Right.
Come see indie bands like us.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, definitely.
Be more value for money seeing you guys anyway. So, yeah.
We put on a pretty good show.
We do.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Okay. Next one then. What's the most important thing to the band right now at this moment in time?
Well, it's two things, new music and touring.
Yeah.
When COVID hit, it hit us hard because we, you know, in 2016, 2017, 2018 and 2019, we toured a lot in Europe.
Yeah.
And we have a lot of friends over there, and we want to get back. So this is such a great opportunity. Who knew it would take 2 years to get back
over there.
Right? Yeah, crazy, so that's, I think that's important. And then new music, the new album, The Siren Rises. We're out on tour right now on the album The Siren. You can pick that up.
Right.
And that's, you know, we love that album, but it's almost 2 years since it came out, and so it's time for
new music.
Time for new music. Yeah. So we played over 110 shows just in America last year, which is the first time we've ever done that. So we're still looking forward. We're going to do some touring in America in 2023, but our focus is going to be Europe and new music.
Epic. That's brilliant. So what's been the most memorable concert then that you played this last year?
Actually, I think our last one, our very last, what it was in December.
Altoona, Pennsylvania.
In Altoona, Pennsylvania. Yeah, we had
we
had the best crowd, so supportive. I'd say that's the first time on our own, because we were the headliners, that we filled a venue front to back. So that was really cool. And they were just so insanely supportive. We actually had
the show was mad. It was crazy.
Yeah, the show was crazy. We had two birthday parties in the audience, which was cool. Right. And we had a little bit of technical difficulties with the sound and actually wound up taking an intermission. And they were so supportive about it, because in my experience, when something goes wrong technically, a lot of times you lose a lot of people, maybe that were like on the fence or like it was late and they just went home or whatever. Yeah. But when we came back, the crowd was bigger.
It was crazy. It turned into a giant party.
Yeah.
Like everyone started moving forward, and we were hanging out. Basically, we had to wait for them to reboot the whole sound system.
Yeah.
We were just hanging out with the audience from the stage, having drinks, conversation. So when we started it back up, it was almost like the show started again.
Yeah.
And the energy level went through the roof. That's the first time that ever happened.
We finished and we actually encored then too.
Yeah, we encored the whole time. I lost my shoes.
Yeah, he came up on stage. He's like, I don't have any shoes on. I'm like, where did your shoes go?
Well, I lost one shoe to the audience. And then it seemed kind of weird to walk around with one shoe on, so I took the other shoe off. The problem with that is at the front of the stage are these metal grates that have lights, and I've always had shoes on stage. I didn't realize they're razor sharp and hot. So that was the first time that ever happened. I did get my shoe back.
Did you? I was gonna say, what, are you not sold on eBay?
I got my shoe back, but I was like, they took my shoe. I'm like, I only have one shoe. Okay, so I was like, I'm gonna have to go around with no shoes. But that was, I think, the cap off 2022.
Yeah, it was a really cool way to end the year. You know, we weren't expecting, and it was actually a fan built show too, because we had met some people at another show we played, and it was about a 2 hour drive to where they lived, and they said, "Will you come up here?"
Yeah,
and they said, "We'll pack the house," and boy, did they! They really, really did.
We had never played in Altoona, Pennsylvania.
Nope.
It was a new market for us. We played in Pittsburgh, and we played in Mechanicsburg and Harrisburg and like all around it. But Altoona, Pennsylvania is a really small town. It's awesome. Nicest people in the world. But it's not like on a tour route. These fans asked us to play, and we were just finishing our touring for December. And we said, if you can get a date in this 2-week period, we'll come play your town. And they did. And then we showed up, and it was mayhem.
It was packed. It was crazy.
That's amazing.
Great time. So
I think everyone's just like wanting to be back out there, aren't they? And to be out there. Yeah. And just be the relief to be back out. It's amazing to have that, honestly. So can you tell me then, what was the last song you listened to today?
The last song we listened to today? Our song. Because we're in the studio, so we're critiquing our work. And actually a song from a local band here called Three Ton. We were working on their stuff too, because we have a little TV show now ourselves, which is kind of new as of 2022. Or it is new.
Yeah, we're...
Is that the Syndicate? Is that what you call it?
Yes. Wow. Yeah, so...
Have you joined the Syndicate?
I just it came up that you joined my meeting, the Zoom meeting. So I guess that's what you're gonna do. That's what it's called. But I will join.
It does.
We didn't change the name.
I will join it.
Yeah, very professional.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's good. So how have you found that with the having your own TV show? Have you got lots of subscribers, or is it taking a bit of time?
It's because it's like normal television. It's not streaming.
Right.
It's taken some time, but it's catching on. And Focus Music TV is kind of, they've kind of brought back almost like MTV. It's dedicated to music. It's on 24 hours a day. And we air Friday nights at 10 p.m. East Coast Standard. And then to see the show, you go on the app, the Focus TV app. But people have been very warm. A lot of bands want to be on it. As you know, it's not the easiest thing to do.
If you got kittens and stuff like that, animals or something,
yeah.
It's true, man. Honestly, I joined TikTok, right? And like, I started putting things up with my kitten and that. You're getting 600 views within a couple of hours. It's crazy. And I've got like nearly 1,000 followers on TikTok. It's just on my cat. It's on my kittens, you know? Or me moaning. When I first started it, I was quite on TikTok a lot. Now I've got bored of it now. But, you know, just people, why do people watch me moaning?
That's true. It's always the joke. You put up the kittens and then put your music video in there.
Yeah.
Back to the kittens.
Yeah.
But no, it's been fun. And the main reason we do it, the TV show, is because Focus TV was following us live when we were on the road. 2021 and 2022, and the owners were like, you should do a TV show.
So we're
touring and doing a TV show at the same time. So it's been pretty busy, but it's also really fun because we get to focus on, like, if we're at a club and they have good food, we'll talk about the food they have.
We
start promoting the venues.
We promote the venue.
Yeah.
And then the main thing, we promote the merch of the bands that play.
Yes.
Yeah,
because that's the best way to support a band, buy a t-shirt.
Yeah.
So it's been fun.
Cool.
But it's always got its challenges. I think we're going to get kittens, though. We're going
to
get kittens.
Do you have to try kittens yet?
Yeah.
So do you use Patreon a lot as well? Are you on that?
No.
Are you on that yet? All right.
We need to get on that.
Yeah.
Send me some info.
I don't know much about it myself, just to know a few other musicians have said about Patreon, and that is like a real big help for them.
Okay.
So yeah, it's worth looking at. I think you can do like exclusives and things like that, can't you? It's all a bit.
Oh, you know what? I do know that actually. Stitched Up Heart.
Oh, okay. Oh,
they
I think
used
I know what
to
it
do
is.
Some
okay.
Patron stuff. Yeah. That was some pretty cool. Their singer would do vocal lessons and stuff.
Yeah, things like that. Yeah, it's worth like looking at. Definitely.
I'll have to give you a percentage if we do it.
Oh, yeah. 10%.
Oh, 10%.
Only 10%. Yeah, I'm cheap. All right, so what would you say is Illusions of Grandeur's biggest selling point? What would you say is Illusions of Grandeur's selling point?
Live shows.
Yeah.
I think you have to see us live. I think we can almost be misinterpreted on an album. And you know, you see us live and you're like, whoa, you know, I didn't realize.
At least we think so.
I think so. I mean, well, I'm very theatrical, you know, right. So I feel like when you're just listening to the album, you're missing a big, huge portion of what the band is really about. You know, there's a whole stage show. I'm constantly trying to get better and add things to it, you know, and I think if you don't see us live, there's sort of a disconnect. If you've never seen any of our videos, go watch our videos, because
it's the music translates and you can get a sense of us. But when we've had a lot of people say to us, I didn't expect what you guys did live. And that's because we bring a lot to it.
Right.
We're talking about ticket prices. If someone's going to pay a dollar that they earned or a pound that they earned to come in, see us play, we're going to give them 110% show.
Yeah, sure.
So we use a ton of lights and video and smoke and all the, and it's a theatrical show. Mm. So it's kind of like, I can always compare it to Alice Cooper or Kiss.
Or Kiss, yeah.
Or maybe
in this moment.
Or scaled down version in this moment. Mm-hmm. But we do our own thing. We try and put that out on videos. We actually just put out a live video called Take Me Alive.
Okay.
And that was filmed at a place called The Vanguard in Hampton, Virginia.
Uh-huh.
It's just us live.
Right.
Because we've had a lot of fans like say, oh, we love your videos and we love your music. But
yeah,
there's not really live videos out. Live is what you're about.
Yeah.
So, I think our selling point is our live.
Yeah.
Cool. So talking about live then, would you like consider ever doing a live album? I know it's not quite the same, like you say, but would you ever consider doing that?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we would. I think once to the entire, the whole saga is put together, that might be something that would be really cool to kind of play out the entire saga front to back, you know, because it's a story. And I've kind of always wanted to get a little bit more into the theater aspect of each song. So you can kind of watch it play out almost like a musical, but, you know, like a rock opera kind of musical-esque.
That's what we've talked about doing, is putting it on, and it's in the works, putting it on stage, not as a rock, well, I guess a rock opera.
A rock opera, yeah.
Like a whole performance.
But, beginning to end performance of all three of the albums, and then, you know, people can see it. I know when I was younger, Iron Maiden, you know, live after death. I mean, you see that even if you weren't a Maiden fan, you became a Maiden fan.
Yeah.
All right. So,
okay, man. Yeah,
not on something probably of that scale, but that would be the idea, is to present the show and present the albums in a row. So it's something that's in the works. And that's where we started with Take Me Alive, the new video.
Uh-huh.
We were doing the videos like The Wolf and Demons, and we present the song, we present the video, and fans, you know, were writing to us or coming up to us live. Like, why don't you have a live video? And it kind of made sense. So we shot it and put it out, and they seemed to like it.
Brilliant. Well, that's good. That's what you want. That's brilliant, man. All right. So can you give me four words to describe Illusions of Grandeur?
Ooh, I guess. I like that. No, I definitely think theatrical.
Yep. Energetic.
Yeah. Energetic. Metal.
And consistent.
Yeah.
You know what? That's a good consistent. Yeah. We every good time price. You see us live, we really prep to go on tour. Like you won't see us. And if you're having an off night,
which all of us do, you won't
know it, because we. When it's time to go on stage, we're like a football team. We focus up, get out there and leave it all on the field.
Brilliant. All right, then, guys. Well, like I say, hopefully I will catch you in the UK, if not definitely Belgium. I want to thank you so much for your time. Looking forward to the next album when it comes out. And hopefully, like I say, I will get down to Oxfordshire somewhere. And we will catch you again. Thank you for your time. Have a happy, happy new year. And, thank you. Take care.
Thank you.
Oh, sorry. Do you have any final words? I meant to say, do you have any final words for your fans, our viewers, and listeners?
I always say thank you so much to everyone. Because even with as far as Illusions of Grandeur has come, you know, without everybody that tunes in and listens to our music and watches our videos and comes and supports us live, there really wouldn't be an Illusions of Grandeur, you know. So the fans are so important to us. And then We have a few people behind the scenes that constantly support us. Uh-huh. My best friend makes all the costumes, and I don't think we could do some of the music videos without her for sure. Uh-huh. So,
and then in 2023, stay tuned for the new single, Midnight.
Yes.
And then we have a brand new website at iogmusic.com. Yeah. It's not up yet.
It's not up yet. We're working on it.
I saw you working on that. Yeah, let's have a look at all that. Yeah, it's a work in progress.
It'll be up soon. It's going to be a little more interactive. Mm-hmm. And it's also, you'll be able to buy our albums directly from us on our website.
Brilliant.
So that's, for 2023.
Awesome. All right, thank you, guys.
If you aim to cheat me, you'll all know.